It should come as very little surprise that the best football teams on earth tend to be based in fairly sizable cities. Take Real Madrid and Barcelona, for example, arguably the two biggest clubs on earth, who are based in the two biggest cities in Spain. The traditional big three in Turkey are all based in Europe's largest city, Istanbul, and whilst it has not historically been the case, the best team in France is now based in the country's capital and largest city. Even with exceptions to this rule, such as in England, where the two most successful teams, Manchester United and Liverpool, are not from by far the nation's largest city, the Greater Manchester and Liverpool urban areas are the second and sixth largest in the United Kingdom. I have had lots of requests over the last 12 months to take a look at seven capital cities with the worst teams, seven capital cities without a top flight team, or the seven largest cities without a top flight team. Essentially, lots of different variations of today's video. Before I start, a number of factors are taken into consideration for the purposes of this seven. It isn't just literally the largest cities without good teams. Otherwise, all seven would probably be in China, with perhaps the odd appearance from Japan, Indonesia, and the like. Also, the seven is based purely on the here and now, so whilst Paris as a city has historically underachieved in football, they are not doing so now, and as such, will not feature. And to make things a little bit more interesting, I'm going to limit myself to one city per nation. Here are seven cities that should have better football teams. Saragossa. The six most successful clubs in Spanish football all hail from Spain's five largest cities. Barcelona, Real Madrid, Athletic Bilbao, Atletico Madrid, Valencia and Sevilla are Spain's six most successful clubs, in that order. Meanwhile, the nation's five largest cities are Madrid, Barcelona, Valencia, Seville and Bilbao, also in that order. Few big countries on earth are a better representation of the success of big city clubs that I alluded to in the introduction. Given that Zaragoza is only the 10th largest city in Spain, yet Real Zaragoza are Spain's 7th most successful football club, one could argue that they have historically overachieved. Real Zaragoza have only actually ever won 9 trophies though, and none since 2004. What's more, this 7 is based solely on the team's current predicaments. Saragossa is a city of more than 600,000 people, and it is part of the autonomous community of Aragon, which has a population in excess of 1.3 million people. Despite that fact, Saragossa and Huesca are the two strongest teams from the region, and neither have ever won a La Liga title. Indeed, currently, neither even compete in La Liga, the top flight of Spanish football. Last season was just about an all-time nadir for football in Saragossa, as Real finished in the bottom half of the Segunda Division. They were in the promotion places when the current campaign was halted, but that's not enough to keep them out of this seven. San Francisco. The United States of America is one of a number of countries in which football, or soccer, still has plenty of room to grow. Nevertheless, I know from running this channel that there is still a very large football-crazed section of the US population, and MLS attendances have been steadily rising since hitting an all-time low at the turn of the millennium. I almost included Chicago, which is the third largest city in the United States behind only New York and Los Angeles. However, soccer is a firm fifth in terms of the most popular sports in Chicago, trailing all the other major league sports, and Chicago do at least have an MLS team. San Francisco is much smaller than Chicago, ranking as the 15th largest city in the United States and the 4th largest in California. Unlike in Chicago though, football is popular in California, hence why the state has 3 MLS teams. Whilst 2 of those teams are based in Los Angeles, the other is based in nearby San Jose, which is part of the San Francisco Bay Area. From the Deltas to the Blackhawks, San Francisco itself has had a string of failed football clubs over the years, and it's perhaps time that that changed. San Francisco City FC are currently the best team in the city, competing in the unofficial 4th tier of US soccer. San Francisco is an international tourist destination that could probably attract top players to the city, and by virtue of that fact, the football club. That, twinned with San Jose's indifferent performances in the MLS since 2012, makes San Francisco a worthy left-field inclusion in this seven, in my book at least. Leeds. I've no doubt that this will be a controversial inclusion, given that Leeds United were enjoying another strong promotion push prior to the EFL season being suspended, but the city of Leeds has long been, and continues to be, an underachieving footballing city in relation to its size. One could make a case for the 3 B's of Birmingham, Bristol and Bradford, but Leeds is technically the 3rd largest city by population in the UK, behind only London and Birmingham. Birmingham currently has a Premier League team with Aston Villa, a Championship team in Birmingham City, and a fellow promotion hopeful of Leeds's in neighbouring West Bromwich. The city of Leeds, in terms of league clubs, only has Leeds United, Despite that fact, Leeds United have only ever won 9 trophies, putting them 15th in terms of the most successful clubs in England, behind the likes of Sunderland and Blackburn Rovers. What's more, the city of Leeds hasn't even had a top flight team since Leeds United's relegation more than 15 years ago. Leeds have never looked more likely of returning to the Premier League than they did before the current season was suspended, but either as a top-end Championship or bottom-end Premier League team, the city of Leeds is punching below its weight. As mentioned, England have a few candidates for this 7, but none finer than Leeds in my personal opinion. Brasília. Brazil is perhaps the most football-crazed nation on earth. Whilst other countries have a big 2, big 3, or possibly a big 6, Brazilian football has a big 12. Considered to be Brazil's biggest and best clubs, Brazil's Big 12 have won all but 6 Campeonato Brasileiro titles over the years. The 12 are dominated by 4 teams from Sao Paulo, 4 from Rio, 2 from Belo Horizonte, and 2 from Porto Alegre. The 4 aforementioned cities rank as the 1st, 2nd, 6th, and 12th largest cities in Brazil. Brazil's capital and 3rd largest city, Brasília, which has a population of almost 3 million people, isn't just unrepresented in Brazil's Big 12, the city doesn't even have a team in the Campeonato Brasileiro at all. Brasília's 2 best teams, Brasileira and Legião, both play in the Estádio Nacional Mané Garrincha, rarely occupying more than 2 or 3,000 of the desolate stadium's near 70,000 capacity. Brasília's lack of footballing prowess is perhaps a consequence of football not being ingrained in the city as it is in Rio or Sao Paulo. Brasília was built in 1960 and took just 4 years to completion, replacing Rio as the nation's capital. Nevertheless, it has been more than half a century since Brasília came into existence, and Brazil's capital and 3rd largest city not being a team in either Brazil's top 2 leagues means Brasília has to take 4th. Ankara. From one major capital city to another, in 3rd place we have Ankara. As mentioned in the introduction, Istanbul dominates Turkey's footballing landscape, with Beşiktaş, Fenerbahçe and Galatasaray having won 55 of Turkey's 62 league championships. Istanbul is by far the largest city in Turkey, but the nation's 2nd and 3rd largest cities are both strong candidates for this 7. Ankara is the capital of Turkey and has a population of almost 5 million people, meanwhile Izmir is the nation's 3rd largest city, home to roughly 3 million people. Basketball enjoys significant support in Izmir, which may have played against the city's football teams, and they have had a Turkish Super League side in Göztepe since 2017. Football is by far the most popular sport in Ankara, home to 2 current Turkish Super League sides, but neither are any great shakes. Between them, Gençlerbirliği and Ankaragücü have won 3 Super League titles, but neither have won a single one since the 1940s. When the current Turkish Super League was suspended, newly promoted Gençlerbirliği were just 3 points above the drop zone, meanwhile Ankaragücü were 2nd bottom. It's a pretty shoddy showing from Turkey's 2nd city and political power base, and one which I think is more than deserving of a bronze medal in terms of this 7. Palermo. Of the 4 largest cities in Italy, Rome, represented by Roma and Lazio, Milan by both AC and Inter Milan, Naples by Napoli, and Turin by Juventus and Torino. The 5th largest city in Italy is Palermo, with a population of more than 650,000, located in Sicily, a region which is home to more than 5 million people. The best team in Palermo and in Sicily is SSD Palermo, who compete in Serie D, the 4th tier of Italian football. Death, taxes, and Italian football clubs going bust are among the 3 certainties in life, and Palermo were kicked out of Serie B despite finishing 11th last season due to their financial struggles. A Phoenix club was formed, restarting life in Italy's 4th tier, and Palermo topped the division when the current league season was suspended. Palermo are both current and historical underachievers in the Italian game, having never won a single major trophy. Meanwhile, smaller cities like Florence, Genoa, and Bologna all have teams who have won 10 major pieces of silverware. It's a long way back to Serie A for Palermo, and given the size of the city, they really ought to have a team fighting for a Europa League qualification at a minimum. Berlin. A very predictable top spot in this 7, I suspect. Germany is Europe's most decorated nation in international football, yet their capital city, and largest city, has lagged behind every other major European capital for decades. As well as being the capital of Germany, Berlin is twice the size of any other German city in terms of its population. In terms of current clubs, the likes of Hamburg and Dusseldorf were both strong candidates for this 7, but neither can rival Berlin in the underachieving football stakes. Hertha are the city's most successful club, and they haven't won a trophy since 2002, and have only won 2 league titles ever. Cities like Mönchengladbach and Kaiserslautern, who are only a fraction of the size of Berlin, can boast teams who have more trophies than Hertha, who are no longer even the top team in Berlin. When the current Bundesliga season was suspended, Hertha were 2 points behind newly promoted crosstown rivals Union Berlin. Whilst there is an enormous passion for football and fan culture in Berlin, that hasn't been matched by success on the pitch. It wasn't long ago that Berlin didn't have a single team in the Bundesliga, which is quite incredible, and even with two teams, both are currently much closer to relegation than they are to qualifying to play in Europe. All in all, no city on earth looks on the face of it as though they should have a big, successful club but lacks one, more so than the German capital of Berlin. That's it for today's video. I will give some quick honourable mentions to the likes of Izmir, Chicago, Dusseldorf, Vienna, Birmingham, Lodz and Bradford. Let me know which cities you think I ought to have included in the comments, along with any other future video ideas you'd like to see from me. Thank you all for watching, hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and obviously, make sure you're subscribed to HITC Sevens.